my name is Donald Holland, and I program, so for the channel, I mean, I do the training along with Adam, but I program for us, and I also do music on the side, but I haven't been streaming music for a while. What got me into lifting was it was after my dad's heart attack, actually. He passed away, and I was like, I'm never gonna let that happen to me, like dying from a heart attack like that. So I got into like bodybuilding first, and then when I got out here, I tried to like get back in bodybuilding, and then we switched over to strongman. And I mean, strength training has been a lot cooler than bodybuilding for me anyway. And I've been lifting since 2012. Dad passed away in 2011, and then I got started January 2012. And then my goals is just like short-term training and entering the next competition. And then long-term is a pro card in strongman. That's what I want to do, and then open up a gym.
My name is Adam Picks. What I do for the channel is I basically, I'm kind of the proprietor of all this. I'm the one that has set all this up. Basically anything you see in here, I've probably bought, I've set up, or I've brung in here. For the most part, what got me into lifting, really it was, at first it was weight loss. Like at first I wanted to lose weight, and I just wanted to get to a certain point where it's like I feel comfortable in my body, and it's like, okay, well, I just want to get down. But then I had this goal of beating my father's numbers, because my father used to be a bodybuilder. And I just had this like ridiculous goal in my head. It's like, oh yeah, you need to beat your dad. Like, you need to beat your dad's numbers. And my dad's numbers weren't no joke. Like, my dad's numbers was 400 squat, 405 pound deadlift, and like a 300 pound bench. So that's no joke, because my dad has been doing it for a long time. And so from that, we just started researching into better ways of like lifting. Because it's like, oh, well, what's the best way to deadlift? What's the best way to squat?
Yeah, specifically deadlift.
And deadlift turned, I believe it was my decision. Like I said, like, let's just do strongman. Let's do strength training. And because that's the way I wanted to go. And it was because of like Brian Shaw's video on like how to deadlift.
Right.
And literally from there, it was just like, we just kept researching, and it's like, okay, well, like, let's try the strongman stuff. Like, what was Brian, like, Brian Shaw's like famous for doing like strongman. Like, I'll just start doing strongman. And from there, it's just continued into fucking obscene, like, shit. And then I've been lifting since 2017. I started lifting in 2012. Literally just for a week. Stopped. And then came back in 2017 and started lifting. And literally has not stopped. I have not stopped training or anything. I have not stopped going to the gym on a consistent basis since 2017, which Don likes. And then
stay consistent.
Goals for me, the short term is to like get to the next competition, basically either in novice or in open category, either way. Or, and then long term is going to be to get on that World's Strongest Man stage or the Arnold stage. and then transfer to World's Strongest Man. Because, yeah, that, like, I just want to, like, just be there. Like, I don't need to win. I just want to be, like, in that name, you know? Like, it's not even about winning at that point, at least for right now. It's just, like, being on that stage, like, being a competitor against some of these guys. Like, it's, like, maybe by that point, like, right now it doesn't seem feasible that I'd be able to beat them and stuff. But it's, like, maybe by that point it's, like, okay, well, I have this down. I have this down. And it's, like, that's more feasible. What about you, Justin? Like, we have a little paper here.
Kind of giving us a little bit of a guide. I mean, my name is Justin Spurgeon. And what I do for the channel, I've only been a part of the channel for, I'd say, 4 weeks. I started lifting over here 6 weeks, but I didn't really get on stream until about a couple weeks in. But I actually started lifting a long time ago, but I never consistently did it. I always had bad form, or I ended up hurting myself, but I've always been an athlete. You know, I played basketball and football in school, but I never consistently lifted because I didn't have the proper form. So I'd always hurt myself. So now, consistently and with proper form, I've been lifting for 6 weeks. These guys have both helped show me the error of my ways, because I would have ended up snapping my shit up if it wasn't for these two guys here. So I thank you guys for that, obviously. But I one of my goals was to be able to actually walk straight, because I have a hip impingement, which some people would call pigeon toe. It's where, you know, I walk with my feet inward slightly. And that would prevent me from ever doing squats, so I never did squats at all. Like, I would be like, no, my knees are going to snap in two. Well, it turns out, after learning stuff, you can actually fix a hip impingement with squatting, because it will actually straighten your legs out. And as a kid, I was told that I would have to have my legs broken and reset to be able to walk a straight line. And when you're a kid and they tell you to, you want to break your legs to walk, you're like, fuck no, I'll walk funny, because I ain't going to be in a wheelchair where all the other kids are on the playground. So I just figured it was something I was stuck with in life. Well, now I'm just now getting to where I have a good squat. So other than that, my goals for lifting have been really just to get stronger, to be in better shape. I'm in my early 30s now, so if I don't do it now, it's going to be too late. So now I just want to try to live a healthy lifestyle, and obviously, you know, be... I'm more of a bodybuilder than doing the strongman, but I do like the strength aspect of it. I mean, I don't want to be one of those guys that looks strong but can't lift shit, because, I mean, you know, that's like having a Dodge Charger with a V6 in it. You don't do that. So I'm doing the program with them that's the power building, which is a little bit of bodybuilding and a little bit of powerlifting. Now, the strongman thing, I've always watched World's Strongest Man. I mean, I watched it back in 07 and 06. But and I've obviously heard of like a lot of the big names, like Brian Shaw and Half Thor, and Pujanowski was the one I grew up seeing. Maurice Pujanowski, that was the guy that was a beast. But the fact that
I thought the beast was Eddie Hall.
Well, yeah, Eddie Hall is the beast. Don't let me get copyright infringement there. But no, what I think is cool that these two do is they do something that's different. I've seen a lot of channels where people, you know, our bodybuilding. Everybody wants to be a bodybuilder. And it's like, it's overrated. And to see them actually doing stuff that...
Hot take.
That bodybuilders can't do. The stone lift, the circus dumbbell, the log press, pushing a car, the yoke run, the farmer's handles. Bodybuilders don't do that shit. And a lot of them can't. And so it's just cool to see them to do that. And what I was going to say about Donald, because I don't really have anything else to say about myself. I mean, plans going forward, I said that, but I wanted to say something about these two that they didn't mention, because being an outside person that knows them. This guy is one of the most dedicated people I've ever met in my fucking life. Not to yank your chain, but seriously.
Yank away.
He doesn't want to do anything fun. He just wants to fucking work. But that could be a good thing. And Adam, what he doesn't tell you is, when in 2012, he couldn't lift shit. Like, I didn't even really know Adam. But people were all talking, oh, this guy can't even bench the bar. Now this motherfucker can lift more than all of them combined, practically. I mean, seriously. And he did it in 2.5 years. It's incredible. It's just, it's cool to me because I remember hearing, oh, he was weak, he couldn't even do this. And now you can't really pan to it, but I look at those numbers and it's like, Jesus. And he did it natural. So, I mean, that's one thing them two didn't mention. But that's all I've got to say, really. I mean, other than that, I'm just kind of following the program, and I'd like to do some of the strongest man lifts with him. Who knows what I'll end up doing. If I end up getting strong in 2 years like this motherfucker did, then maybe you never know. But one day at a time.
Well, it's like, for myself, like, I literally, like I said, I haven't stopped. I just have not stopped, like, lifting at all. Like, I have followed the program to, like, a certain T. Like, I haven't followed the program exactly. And I'm not going to claim that. I'm not going to claim I followed the program. I've done all the shit on that program. No. Like, because but for the most part, I followed the program to a certain extent, and I've put myself in a situation where my lifts are coming to a point where it's like, hey, like, this is getting serious now. Like, your shit is, like, getting to that status of, like, you could punk some motherfuckers out. Yeah, like,
it's true, though, man. Like, it's impressive.
I'm,
a scouting report on the competition. No, I'm kidding.
No, he's gonna have some flashbacks right now. I think Kobe went against you, Don.
Oh, they actually have him. He's on there, too? So I can see what he looks like? Okay.
He's probably in the back. No. He's after you. Yeah. In the squat, or in the yoke event.
In everything. He's, like, literally right up. But you'll be able to see him during the,
so the times that I have on here are, so I had a 15.47 second yoke run.
So were they all having trouble picking it back up afterwards? Is that where the trouble was at?
The trouble was the fucking rain. Like, that was the trouble.
Because I noticed he struggled. He was, like, with you on the way down, and then he struggled to get it back up, and then you...
it's a little bit of everything. I mean, the environment, and it was heavy. Some people didn't the yoke to train.
I got you.
They didn't have the implement.
Yeah, we trained the yoke like fucking crazy.
Yeah, you could tell, man. You picked that right back up, no problem. It's booking it down here.
And there's Don.
I just didn't want to crawl. But that dude smoked me right there.
So... that was better than what we did in training, too. Mm-hmm. So what we did in training, I got down to a 17, I believe, once. 17 second.
Yeah, I don't think you ever
got so down the people in the crowd right there, they're all just watching, right?
Dude looks like he should be a big... No, that guy, he's in the super heavyweight category.
I was getting ready to say, because that guy looks like he should be in competing.
No, he was in the super heavyweight category. Super nice guy, too.
He's the one that was going to be putting on the Beast of the Bay.
Yeah.
Oh, like actually putting on an event?
Competition. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's cool.
Mm-hmm. Looks like a pretty big guy. Is he pretty strong?
Oh, yeah. That's the they all got beat out by a middleweight. Or he was like 2 pounds away from being like a middleweight. He's the lightest guy.
And And this is the power stair, duck walk into power stair. Yeah. Fucking worst event.
Yeah, this is this one sucks. I'm so nervous.
How much weight is that again?
That's 300 and...
150 kilos.
Like, Don's telling me shit here. I cannot hear him. 313.
He was pumped after you got that
thing. Yeah, because it was the first time I ever did it.
I was so nervous, like I dropped it, and I was like, dude, my nerves were getting to me.
You can tell, you have shorter legs, so you can't widen them as much. Yeah.
So, I was like, oh no, I have to at least get one stair. I have to.
You ended up getting two, correct?
Yeah.
Same fucking DZs.
Yep. Yeah, no shit.
And then, yeah, the third one, I was so close. Yeah. See, I was almost there, but I just could not. I could not trust myself to go back.
Without falling?
Right. Even though we did have somebody there who'd actually catch us.
Is it playing? Is it playing for you guys?
I'm getting busted this out so you can see the chat right here.
Well, that's not, where is it? Is it still loading up?
No, it's like no one's talking.
Nobody's talking.
Let me rewind. Oh shit. Let me rewind it.
It wasn't heavy. It was, awkward. Yeah, very awkward. I had bruises on my calves.
Were you bigger than
from
you
it? Yeah.
You look bigger. I was
265 or 266 pounds.
Oh, way behind.
Yeah, I just noticed like that.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Let's see.
Kobe said I'm back.
Yeah, I saw.
Okay. Yeah, it looks like it played through. Right?
No, because it's on this. No, Adam.
It is, but it's lagging, though, right?
No, Adam, it's not playing.
Oh. Can we just bring in the full thing and cut us off, like...
Just hear the commentary?
Right.
That's probably too much for it. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know why I'm even commenting. I have no fucking clue. I've never streamed.
I can hear it, but I'm fine.
Online, man, because... Because I sucked at Call of Duty. Everybody else has been playing for so long.
The video is the 805 strongest, just like me and Adam's lifts, just on the events. Probably actually see you, Kobe, standing right behind me during the Atlas Stone.
Still isn't playing right, is it?
No. That was mine.
Oh, was it?
Oh, no, it wasn't.
Oh. Yeah, somebody else is streaming. So once we can get it figured out. It's killing time. Dude, you look like you were about to pass out right there. Fall down those steps, man.
Oh, I've seen that emotion. This dude shows no emotion.
Me?
Yeah, you really don't. It's hard to tell. It takes a lot to get you like really excited.
It has to be, to be a big thing.
Like,
yeah.
The lifts, I'm like, damn, that's a lot. He's like, yeah, it's no fucking big deal. Like, it takes like something like crazy. Which is a good thing, I mean, because that means your goals are set higher.
Okay.
If you take something big to get you going.
It's still not showing. I do not know why.
How did we run it into Streamlabs last time? I mean, you had the two screens, yeah, but...
No, I literally just had it on my...
Was it just a screen capture?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I could do that.
Display right, camera. Yeah, hopefully no rain. That was... It was horrible, having that rain.
I fucking hated myself, because it was like... I was getting wet, and then not only was I getting wet, I was tired as fuck.
I'm curious, Kobe, did you bring anything to eat at the 805? Tell me you weren't, like, an idiot like me and Adam. Because we didn't bring anything to eat.
Display capture.
I'm just glad the yolk was the first thing, and it was on an empty stomach, and I have more energy on an empty stomach. He was going to bring, you didn't actually go and get any Pedialyte, did you?
No, I just had a protein bar.
Yeah, we were going to bring, like, the big things of Pedialyte.
Like the jugs.
You see, like, power lifters, like, drinking that.
Yeah,
during
it's stronger
their
than Gatorade.
Yeah.
Sure.
And you get all the electrolytes. Gamers 410 stream. I brought too much to eat.
Why didn't you give me any?
Who'd you get that banana from?
I got stuff from, like, different people. Like, one of them was...
The mosquito on your face, man. Yeah, it just landed, like, on your fucking face. I watched it. They're getting desperate because we sprayed all of our limbs. Yeah, I mean, it must have flew off, but, man, I saw that shit. It was like, I was about to have its face bit. That's the worst place to get bit by, too, because it swells up, like, way bigger. This is the time of day for them motherfuckers.
Yeah, you know, we saw people who had, like, big meals from, like, Denny's or IHOP.
I bet you guys were like,
it was, like, big old stacks of pancakes.
Troubleshooting. Adam is troubleshooting right now.
Yeah, we'll have it up here in a second.
There you go. There you go.
Yeah, buddy.
There you go.
All right.
And only me. That's right.
Now, guys, it's killing time. Fear in the dark.
Only stops in the stop. The longest lighter than 200 pounds.
He's kidding. Hopefully, he's kidding. Because, like, if that's true, I might as well go into that competition and fucking smoke everyone.
Yeah. Yeah, but a 260-pound
Oh, I could do that.
Don't look at me, man. I'm not doubting this motherfucker's abilities. I listen to motherfuckers make fun of the bar. Yeah, I ain't saying shit no more. I ain't. Stronger than me. Both of y'all are stronger than me.
Playing now? Okay.
But pound for pound, okay, cool. Ball,
I already saw myself, yeah.
But yeah, like, I had a ton of fun going, and everyone was so nice. Like, everyone,
that's what I liked.
Yeah, everyone was just so, like, on your back, and it's like you need to, like, people yelling at you like, finish, keep going.
During this moment right here in particular, they were like, come on. It got loud as fuck in there during that moment.
Dude, remember I couldn't even talk.
After
the log press.
This was a 210-pound log. The worst part is like having to like come back down on your chest. It's like, what?
You can see it bracing itself for you, it's absorbing.
Gluten.
You saw that guy touch me? I didn't feel that.
Oh, it was, the log was supposed to be 200 pounds for the 805. And then, O changed because the axle was going to be 210 for reps.
Yeah, it was supposed to be, the circus dumbbell into the log into the axle for reps.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And we trained the axle for reps, like, hardcore. And then we checked the fucking time,
mm-hmm.
not the time, but the competition page.
Yeah.
And it was like, oh no, it switched. And then me and him both looked at each other. We're like, what the fuck just happened? And then we checked the Facebook page. The Facebook page says something different than the fucking
than
the official website.
So we're like, somebody to what the hell do we do? How do we change up the training to...
That's why Big John, when he came out, he's like, everyone ready for something you didn't train? Like, he literally said that to everyone, like, on mic and everything. He's like, everyone ready for something you completely didn't train? It's like,
So we had the 200-pound log down for one, perfect.
Yeah, officially.
And then
yeah.
I actually, like, I struggled with the log because our training changed. So I was like, man, now I have to try to be, like, 10 pounds heavier on the log to what I trained for. I was like, man, this is one of my favorite lifts, too. So, yeah, I got it up. And I was like, yeah, at least I got one. At least I don't look like a little bitch in front of everybody. I ended up getting 3 reps.
So you do one more?
Or no, in training night I got 2, in competition I got 2. So I was glad that I at least
hit training.
Yeah, hit the same amount that I did in training. And at that point I was like, I don't have to. Yeah.
They call time. Yeah. Yeah, that's the Alice one.
It's the Stone of Steel.
Oh, that's the guy that gave me the banana in the back.
Right behind you?
Yeah. The guy with the Cerberus belt. And there's Kobe at the corner with the power shirt. I'm so mad. I was so mad about that. Okay. Can I talk about that for a sec?
Yeah.
Can I talk about that fucking rep for a sec? That rep
probably
so fucking
fall over your back.
No.
Right, if it falls over your back,
it's a no rep.
You showed no control over.
So they didn't count that?
They didn't count it.
Oh.
Because you didn't have control of it.
I would have been pissed.
I was, like, at the time, I wasn't mad, but then, like, later on, I got pissed. And I was just like, It was just so bad. And then I think I only got like 4 or 3 reps.
Yeah. And you got 3 in this one, I got 5.
And I did better because of that one that rolled off my back. I did better than I did in training because I only did 3. So I technically did 4 per se, but only one of them was like not counted.
You actually did the 200-pound stone for 1 in training. You got 1 in 60 seconds. And I ended up getting 3 in 60. Kobe said, there's me. Yep.
Yeah, there's Kobe in the
Where
background.
Where is he?
He's the one all the way at the end with the power shirt.
The tall one?
What, yeah, the one right that's on the full, like, this side of the screen over there.
Oh,
there.
Right over here. Okay,
yeah,
that's
uh-huh.
right now.
Yeah, that's
okay. Yeah, with the hair over.
So, I guess, let's see. So, he wasn't directly after me.
No.
The
only difference
guy.
In that first one is it fell backwards. You still had it, though. That's why I was, like, kind of confused.
Well, like, if it rolls off the back, it's showing no control.
I got you.
That was their rule. They said that before we did the lift.
I mean, he gave you that one right there, and that one was a little iffy.
Shut the fuck up.
Because it started rolling, like, down.
I knew that was way down.
But the guy was, he was really nice about it, the judge.
Well, because we were all novice, so.
Yeah, he was like, just get your arm off the ball.
I didn't even train half the events.
Yeah, this is my favorite.
Yes. I want that fucking stone. I want that stone of steel. But it's like fucking $900. That's a $900 piece of fucking equipment.
Damn.
Well worth it, though.
Yeah, because you could go up to like 500 pounds on a stone.
How much was that stone weigh right there then?
190.
Which was lighter than what it was supposed to be.
No, it was supposed to be 180. And they
oh no, it was heavier, right.
Yeah, it went up by 10 pounds.
But it still felt light. Like when we had it, when it was empty, it felt like nothing.
Yeah, and then it was time before I could get into this. And then lost wrestling.
You did
alright
though, didn't you?
No. I mean, I only beat this one guy.
Yeah, and this guy was hilarious.
Was he mad?
Yeah, he was pissed. Because I think at this point, if I beat him, or if he beat me, he would go to, like, the semifinals.
He was salty.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, look at
especially
his
face. Especially here, like.
Like, look at his face.
I just did not want to, like, give up my, like, grip was there. Like, I was not going to give up my grip. If anything, they were going to pull me over to the other side. My grip was going to be solid the entire time.
He's trying his ass off to beat you, too.
Yeah, he's just like... Like, at the end of that, he's just like, oh, my God. See, you see what that guy did? I did the same thing here, where I just try to use brute force against this guy. But I like this guy. Like if I saw him today, I'd still give him a hug, because he was super nice. But, yeah, see, he was pulling me, like, up. Because I was just trying to, like, outforce him.
I never did the stone shoulder, and we never did the 210 pound log.
I think you mentioned that when we talked to him.
But, I was really.
But this is funny. So I hug the guy. She gets in between me and him. She's like, "No, fuck you! Like you, this is how we do this." But yeah, I officially.
Where did you place Kobe?
I think he placed higher than me.
How much stronger do you think you are? from then to now.
Oh, fucking way stronger. Like, ridiculously stronger.
What was your numbers then, do you remember? Or did you guys even keep track of it?
Oh, yeah. We kept track of
him. Motherfucker tricked him.
He had the 500-pound deadlift before we went, and 475-pound squat.
Oh, yeah. Way stronger. You weren't lying. Way stronger. That's over 100 pounds on each one of those lifts.
And it was like a 235-pound bench, and the overhead was 180 or 190.
And I bet you
185.
I bet you could eclipse that 280 bench now. I bet you could.
I'm not super sure about that.
I think you could just because your pressing strength is probably up too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, everybody was awesome there. I mean, just the amount of support that everybody gave, everybody showed.
Well, it was like a ton of fun too. It was like
second to last is what he placed.
Oh damn!
I thought you were like way higher than that.
Yeah. Because there was, 15 people in our thing?
Yeah. In our novice category.
Well, he said he didn't train anything. So that's probably why. I'm sad. If I didn't do Moss Wrestling, I would have got, second place.
That's the thing that held you back the most?
Well, if I zeroed out on a certain event, like one of them, I believe my worst event was the stone. So if I zeroed out on stone, yeah, I would have gotten a better placing. I would have gotten at least second. Or no, I think it was third that would, like, we talked about. Because we saw the paper. Because we stayed, we literally stayed. 3 hours after the competition, because that's how long it took them to fucking put the list together.
Really?
It took them 3 hours to calculate everything.
That's crazy.
Everyone else had, the right idea. I think, Kobe, you left, too. Everyone had the right idea to leave, because it was, so long.
You could have got the results later anyways, right? But you guys wanted to see them right then and there.
He sent the... Remember, he got the... I think it was... in the team.
Oh yeah.
Category. Where I think you were the strongest team.
That's awesome. Oh yeah, that's cool as fuck.
But he was also the biggest one too. Not to diss, but he was the biggest one. But yeah, my thoughts on the first Strongman competition were literally just we came super ill prepared, number one, and then number two, we should have trained the events better, in my opinion. What's up, my guy? How you doing? We're just talking about strongman and stuff like that right now. No, I stayed to the very end. That's right, because I was talking to you. I fucking forgot. I'm sorry.
Okay, novice heavyweight. There we go.
He's literally looking. He has the PDF.
Yeah, so he did 14.
Damn.
Out of 15. And
wait,
that
isn't
was,
that isn't that last?
That Eric Brewster, he didn't show up, right?
No. He didn't.
Yeah. So it's pretty much last in that.
I got third in teens out of three.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because Ode is really, really for young people going into strongman. I believe. They gave all three of them a tub of fucking pre-workout, but protein or a mass gainer.
The team heavyweight category.
Yeah.
Yeah, Bradley Hale. Bradley Nate and Kobe. Kobe, you gained weight. Says you were 345.
In at 259.
Well, I gained weight.
So I guess I wasn't. That's fucking weird.
Huh?
I thought I weighed in at like 265, remember?
Yeah, well, they put you down.
259. So apparently I weighed in at 259.
Oh, so you were lighter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wasn't.
That's right, because then if you remember I mentioned, if you lost like, I think it was like 5 pounds or something, you would have been able to go into the middleweight.
No, 230 is middleweight.
Sad day. There's a teen category this year.
230 is middleweight.
Are you in that?
UFC 185.
Or are you just in the open?
205. Oh yeah.
No, 205 is lightweight, heavyweight.
Huh? Oh, is it?
In MMA, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Middleweight's 185.
Okay, we don't talk about MMA in here. So. Fuck out with that.
Well, there's a we and there's a me. And I'll talk about whatever that
is. And you could jack off my we, okay?
Hold on, let me get a pair of tweezers.
No, you need chopsticks.
Alright, I don't want to give you a sweater.
He
though,
weighed okay. in at 239 pounds, pretty much. And in the open heavyweight category, he weighed in at 239 pounds. And then you see the other two. That one that you were like, yeah, he looks like a strong man. That's Tommy Burns.
Yeah, he weighed
300. Big boy Burns.
Yeah.
Who's Dustin Gonzalez weighing a whopping almost 380 pounds? He's a big guy.
I don't think you saw him.
And Preston was only 283 pounds.
Preston's not that thick. He's a lot of muscle. Preston's also a really nice guy, too.
Who was it that I went up against?
Legit, like, I, yeah, I'm in teens, I'm 17. Kobe, did you go to, Arnold Santa Monica?
I had to go up against him.
Oh, yeah, the fucking 300-pounder?
303 pounds.
Edgar Sanchez?
Yeah.
303 pounds?
That's who I lost to in the first round.
Who's that biggest guy?
He just
guy
fucking picked me up.
Yeah, he pulled him. I wish
Kobe was 346?
Yeah, he pulled Don over the fucking railing.
I was like, once I was almost in the standing position, I just let go. I was like,
imagine from that position, you just like, and it's like bar out of your hand.
I was like trying to like go like that to sort of like roll back and force myself to sit back like, down.
Could it?
And it was like,
but it
was like me against a damn boat.
Like, who's gonna put the boats in?
Apparently that guy.
Jeff, I think, was the heaviest.
Yeah, he's really big.
Big boy. No, I couldn't go.
That's
yeah,
what you think of.
Yeah, because who was it? Fuck. I'm blanking on his name right now. Give me 1 second. I'm so sad that I'm like forgetting his name. Oh yeah, Phil. Because Phil gave us like really good seats for Arnold Santa Monica. Like, really, really good seats. Because there was, like, a little section that they had for just them. Because they were, like, let in, like, really, really early. because they're like Martine's people. Remember that? And like Phil let us in, and we were just talking to Preston like the whole fucking time. Preston and Jeff. I think we were talking to Jeff. Oh no, we were talking to Will. The dude with the fucking crazy grip.
Oh my god, you beat him on Moss? Was that just like his grip gave out? Or did you like pull him up? Because he weighed in at 351 pounds.
Probably grip. I don't like Moss. I don't like Moss as a strongman thing. I know that's Oates' thing. But it's like there should have been another strongman event there. Like I get there was like 120 people there, like competing.
18 in December.
Well, talking about December, so how's COVID?
Oh, okay. Affected the training.
Yeah, like,
I mean, it was just for us. It was LA Fitness shut down, and then we scrambled to like get all of this put together. So just training in general for like competitions has sort of died down a little bit. But next year we'll come back.
Yeah, like I actually like having like this year off, personally. I honestly think it's a big help because I'll be competing against Jeff.
Oh yeah, ab cramp.
Oh.
Remember you got that too, right?
Well, that's because my fucking core was messed up at the time. I literally went through a fucking gallbladder surgery.
That's a pretty good excuse. We sat down. We're like getting trained by like a world expert.
Two of them. Because Martins showed
champion,
up.
Yeah. Martins and Osipova. We were, like, being trained by two, like, world champions at Moss Wrestling. And it was me versus Adam. And, you know, Adam's still, like, bigger than me. And, like, I'm winning against him on it. Because my grip. Like,
and my core.
He had, like, his abs.
Bro, like I could. I still have the fucking cut.
Yeah, that's legit. That's a legit. That's a legit point, though.
I have three holes and that big ass cut. So it's like.
Who was the other guy? They're training us. But I hate that I forgot his name.
Phil. Phil and
no, I mean in Moss. It was that tall dude that whooped me every fucking time. Yeah, it was like, oh yeah, you think you're fucking tough? Let me go ahead and sit down. And it's like this dude's like training for like worlds in Moss wrestling.
Yeah.
And it's like, mm-hmm. Yeah, like every time he would smoke me. Because he'd be like, what? Him? Fucking, like, just take off to one side. Me? And it'd be like, again, like Osipova. Again. Again. Me? Oh, my God.
Cody.
Cody, yeah. Cody was whooping my ass.
It's fucked up because Cody was so nice, too. He's like... And he has like a really light voice, so he's like, yeah, like you need to like go like this, and
yeah.
Super light voice, like not really like a
intimidating demeanor.
Yeah,
like expect.
But like when you get against the bar with him, I remember I saw Don, like, get beat, like, three times. I'm like, yeah, I'm not. Like, he's like, you want to, like, I'll teach you. It's like, no, I'm good.
Like, and Sardana was, like, on the side, like, Moss fucking wrestling, relentless. See,
like, it's kind of a different strongman. Like, it's not.
It's not strongman.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, it seems different. It looks
like, in my opinion, it's not a strongman event. It's just something that Ode does. Like, it's just something he does. So
it's
he
his
wants,
event, so he puts on what?
Yeah.
It'd be like going in and, like, one year they did have, what, like, sumo wrestling or something like that. And it's like, you shouldn't be going against a person. You should be going against a weight.
Right.
This way everybody has, like, the same, like, opportunity.
Well, like, granted, World's Strongest Man used to have, like, sumo events.
No, that's what I'm saying. So. Yeah. They used to do, like, sumo wrestling.
But that kind of became obsolete. I don't do it anymore.
Right.
It became obsolete because it doesn't really seem like it belongs to me. To me, once you're going head to head with a person, it's not. It's more about energy and size. Because I mean, the
weights
are still the same, but a person is different sizes. You know.
That's why I love the fucking grip test, like that grip test that Brian Shaw fucking lost. Brian Shaw lost a grip test to Martins. That shit was fucking hilarious. So, in case you didn't watch it, so 2019, World's Strongest Man, Martins had all this chalked up. Brian Shaw had this chalked up. That's it. Just hands and this. So, he came out, and it is humid as fuck, because it's Florida, and Tampa Bay, Florida, and... So they're doing a, I think it's like a 400 pound car deadlift.
And holding.
So you're holding 400 pounds for like max time. Brian Shaw was like in it to win it. Like he, like everyone was like, oh yeah, Brian Shaw's gonna fucking win. Like because he has a really good fucking grip. Like he has one of the best grips out there. And I think it was like in 20 seconds he dropped it. And everyone was like, what the fuck? Like, what happened? Like, what? And it was like, oh, okay, well.
Oh, damn, you snapped one in half? Is that what that is?
What?
You, like, snapped one of those sticks? Like Moss wrestling sticks?
Damn.
That's what it looks like.
I don't blame you.
Like, snap that shit in half?
It doesn't deserve to be in strongman.
You see that? Currently 4:53 a.m. in Scotland, staying up all day to fix my sleeping pattern.
Ash, I will never understand you. I will never understand your mode of logic ever. But
he's trying to reset it, I think. Stay up and then fall asleep at a certain time and reset it. Maybe.
Yeah,
we got it.
Yeah. That's crazy.
But for us, the whole, like, pandemic, luckily it didn't hit us as hard as it probably hit most other people that I've heard. Like, a lot of my friends that train to just train, like, they don't do anything, they just work out. They're like, oh, like, I wish I had this or that. And it's like, well, yeah, but, like, you should have got it beforehand.
It did. It messed up one thing. We were planning on revisiting the 805 strongest in the novice category for the second time, and
you got canceled. You know,
and then it's like it was unpredictable. So like it could still be going on.
That's my blood on it. Oh fuck!
Where'd you stick it?
Dude, imagine like in the middle
that
of
that could have been bad. That could have really fucked you up. Stabbed right through your fucking hand or some shit.
Barbell movements for strongmen in a regular gym. That was asked by Ash. So I would say, like your regular SPD, or like squat, deadlift, overhead, and then like having incline press, having some sort of a pin squat, because some places or some events that you might end up doing are like a pin squat.
Right. And then
for
rack pulls.
Rack pulls for deadlifts, yeah. And then like doing a car deadlift. Like if you're like the way that we did it with the trap.
Yeah. That was sort of cheating.
Trap
though.
Machine. Well, kind of, but it's still like...
You're not going to have anything behind you that you can sort of push off. Ain't no business, not a joke.
Well, yeah, but, you know, like, that's still training, in a sense, for, like, a car deadlift. And it honestly matters for, like, strongman training, like, what your events are.
If the bar is in front of you, rack pulls for car deadlifts is just as good. If they're on the sides, that's different. If you have a hex bar in the gym, use that. Train for car deadlifts.
Do that, like, 1,000-pound fucking hex bar. How do you start making your own programs?
You find one on the internet that you like. You put in stuff that works for you, for like your assistants and your accessory work, and then just it depends. If you're going for like strength, then you want to keep it in the 3 to 6 range for the reps, and then bodybuilding, if you're adding any of that, it's like 8 to 12 reps, and then like 3 to 4 sets in those ranges for whatever you're doing. I mean, I would look up stuff that, you know, do your regular stuff. Do like the SBD
or power building, or you can do both.
Yeah,
which you can you have us on now.
I would start looking at like programs for like power lifters. Like look up powerlifting programs first, and then start adding things in that's going to help you achieve what you want. So any like 1 to 2 assistance lifts per muscle group, and then some accessory in there. You know, if you want to add like bodybuilding to it. But that's how I started, just finding like a powerlifting program, taking like their rep ranges for the main lifts, and then adding in our assistance lifts.
You guys both started off bodybuilding, didn't you?
Did Chris Gethin's plan, and then Arnold's, and then
we switched over to 5x5,
and then the wrong way.
Yeah,
let's get that clear.
Really wrong.
Yeah, the wrong way. We were doing an actual 5x5 with deadlifts. You're not supposed to do that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you do a 5x5 with deadlifts. You deadlift once a week.
Then what'd you do wrong?
We
added all the assistance lifts on top of it, 5x5. So we were doing flat bench, and then incline bench, and decline bench.
All
five
at 5x5?
Yeah. We were doing deadlifts and rack pulls, 5x5, and squats, and what else was for like the squats?
It was a hack squat, or like the leg press.
Yeah, something
it was some
that.
Shit like that.
No, I know what overtraining feels like. I've been there, done that.
Luckily, I never got to that point.
That's not really overtraining. That's just like, I mean, that's what happens when you don't use those muscles a whole lot, and then you just fucking work them to death.
Destroy
you can't
them.
Walk afterwards. That shit's overtraining, motherfucker. I don't care what you say. Maybe they weren't used to it, but still, they got overtrained.
So, like, what supplements do you recommend for weightlifting, food-wise, powders, shakes, like those kinds of things? So, like, for myself, I use gym protein. And, well, I take a couple supplements. So, I take C4 for my pre-workout. And then I take, MuscleTech?
Creatine.
And then I take gym protein. I switched from Syntha 6 to gym because I just want to see how it works on my body, if it, like, does anything different. So far, I feel less groggy after I take it. Like, I feel like I can still eat with gym protein. Like, I normally take 2 scoops, like, regardless. I only take a 2-scoop a day thing of protein, and that's it. If I need more, I'll take more. But for the most part, that's what I'm taking. And then I also take an animal pack. I've stopped taking it. I only take it, like, once a week now. Because it's like, I want to see if
it's actually helping.
Yeah. So I take it once a week with food. So I try to eat something with it.
Yeah, I don't know. Vitamins are either fat soluble or water soluble, so you need a fat and water.
I think with the animal pack, it's both.
Yeah, it has both kinds of vitamins in it.
I would take it 2 days a week for you at the moment, on your squat day and on your deadlift day, because those are the heaviest days, and it's you want to take it when you're, like, really working your ass off.
See, I noticed you had me try animal pack a long time ago, right? Mm-hmm. And I noticed at first, for like the first week when I took it, I felt great. And then after that, I went back to normal, and all it was my kidneys started hurting because I was pissing it all out. But at the time, I didn't know, you know, that there were water soluble and fat soluble vitamins. Plus, when it comes to me, I noticed I have to have all natural vitamins. I can't have fake vitamins. They all have to be whole food, organic, real vitamins for me to absorb it. If I take, like, any of the synthetic shit, it goes right out of me. Either it goes out my ass or, you know what I'm saying? I won't absorb it.
Who else uses it?
Which I wish I wasn't like that.
Protein. There's somebody that I follow.
Eddie.
That uses it.
He's what?
Is it?
Protein?
Oh, okay. Yeah, Eddie Hall.
He uses what?
He's literally the fucking face.
Yeah, protein.
I never heard of it.
And G Fuel. I've never heard of that pre-workout.
It's not even a pre-workout. It's more, it's a gamer supplement. That's literally what it's called, G Fuel, Gamer Fuel.
Oh.
Really?
Yeah.
Like a pre-workout or like
it's not
energy
drink? It's an energy drink, basically.
Oh, okay.
Which could be, you could call
but it. But like you, like they claim that you get like enhanced focus and stuff. Like there's like certain things in it that some pre-workouts have. Yeah, I would understand why you would take that. It's kind of a cleaner pre-workout in a sense, but like
I mean, sometimes we use 300 milligram
rock stars,
yeah, 300 milligram caffeine rock stars for pre-workout.
My favorite pre-workout.
They take like so many more supplements than me.
Oh really?
Not really, no. Yeah.
I mean, we were taking Alpha Brain at one point.
Yeah, but we ain't taking that anymore. And I didn't really even feel a difference coming off of it. I didn't. Personally.
Dude, I felt like shit for a few days.
Not me.
After that.
But my favorite pre-workout I used to use was Woke as Fuck. Bucked Up, Woke as Fuck. They had that and then the BAMF. That shit worked the best for me. And I went from that and I used to drink the cans of C4. And I liked that too, like the bombsicle flavored cans. I didn't even realize that they had powdered versions of C4. I just used to pick that up when I ran out.
I mean, at one point we were using
C4 too.
Bang for...
See, I never
drank
the Bangs.
We would drink like a Bang at LA Fitness.
Yeah, I remember that.
Get like a case of Bang.
See, I always stuck with Monsters. I like them the best for energy drinks. But I did like the fuck out of that Fruit Punch Rockstar, man. That shit was good.
But that only has like 240
milligrams. 240 caffeine. Or 260, I think it said. And you guys don't like that pre-workout over there? I fucking like it. It works well.
Well,
for me.
It doesn't work well for like what we do.
I mean, when you take it and instantly like get a pump, and it's like, okay, now my legs need to like be able to take a 400 pound squat on top of it.
I didn't really get the pump from it. I don't get the pump until I use the muscle. I mean, that's how.
That's what we're saying. Like, we could start doing like a 225 squat, and then it's like we start feeling that pump going.
No, I mean, I got it. Like, I took it, and instantly my arms became like more like veiny and shit, and like instantly I got like a pump. My tendons started hurting. Like.
Is that the same thing that you did the overhead press where your head was red as fuck?
No. I took C4 that day, I believe.
Different strokes move different folks, man. You know what I mean? Like, it didn't do that to me. And I get a good effect from it.
I was like, oh my God, man. My fucking arms are like...
I get a good effect from C4, too, and everything else.
So, so another question was, is cardio necessary for weightlifting? And in my opinion, yeah, I would say no. But it would depend on your goal.
Nothing is necessary. I mean, it just depends on what you're looking to do.
Well, here's the thing. Depending on the rep range of weightlifting is cardio. When you do 100 reps or something, you're doing cardio. I would say if you've never lifted weights in your life and you have no cardio, then that's bad. You need to have some cardio. You know, if you're at least walking is cardio. If you're just someone that went from straight up being all you did was sit on the couch, going straight to weightlifting without cardio, then cardio is necessary. That would be the only time I would say it would be.
And I mean, depending on like the type of cardio too.
Right.
You know, if you're doing like HIIT training.
Yeah, that's high intensity cardio.
Muscular endurance training, like
which
what
is
we
marathon,
do.
Like marathon training.
Yeah, and I mean, you sort of have to have it. When you're doing like max reps in strongman, your muscles have to be able to endure like how many reps you're putting it through.
Well, and the better cardio you have, the more you'll be able to lift heavier longer, because the blood, your heart's pumping blood to those muscles, and when you have a good working heart, those muscles are staying fueled. You know what I mean? But can you still get stronger without doing cardio?
Yeah,
absolutely.
100%. So, when do you know to go up in weight? That's the last question.
I mean, you have to at the end of the program. I mean, find a program, go through it.
Well, what happens if their program doesn't have linear progression?
We don't have linear progression right now.
No.
But at week 8, we're still going to max out.
Yeah, but like, even if. So, yeah, they're like, well, how do you know you should go up, like, at the end of the program?
At the end of the program, that's when you try to go up.
When you feel stronger. If it was a weight before, a weight before that you could only do 3 reps and you're doing 6, you're probably going to go up in your max.
If you're doing bodybuilding, you should be going up, like, every week.
Progressive overload.
Yeah, you should be overloading your muscles every single week.
Even if it's going up by 2.5 pounds.
Right.
Or, you know, 0.5 pounds, whatever you got to do to go up.
If you're doing powerlifting, you need to go through the entire program before you attempt to, like, go up.
Adam could have his own show just for the facial expressions this fucker makes, man. He cracks me the fuck up. I can't help it.
Well, it's like...
That's why if you see me laughing randomly, it's because of Adam's facial expressions. They kill me.
But, yeah, I think that... There's
people out there who, like, will attempt to, like, try and go up in their lifts, like, every week, and it's like, you are just fucking yourself over.
Yeah, maxing out every week.
Yeah, maxing out every week is not a good idea.
Well, you see that a lot in, like, public gyms anyway. Mm-hmm. Like, it's very common. And then, like, if you see someone, like, try to tell that person, like, hey, like, you shouldn't do that, then that person's, like, ostracized for being like, oh, you don't know what you're talking about.
They'll name the one guy that does it and is successful. And it's like, okay, there's always one guy that can do it, but most people can't. So, oh, well, this guy does it. Yeah, that guy is a fucking freak of nature. You're not.
Yeah, I was
you know
on.
What I'm saying?
I was
but
on
most
stream.
People can't. Or that guy's on steroids.
I was
you're
on
not.
Stream the other day. This guy brought up this one bodybuilder or whatever, or powerlifter. I don't know what he is. But he's all like, why do bodybuilders only do like 5 reps of like 400 pounds?
You mean powerlifters?
No. Bodybuilders. He said bodybuilders.
Yeah, so
and it's like they don't.
Yeah, they do 8 to 12.
So he's all like, why do they only do like 5 reps when this other guy was doing like fucking he did 500 pounds for 23 reps. And it's like, why can't other bodybuilders do that? And it's like, well, the dude probably has some genetics that's like predisposing him to that.
Mm-hmm. Or like steroids.
Or yeah, roids. And like the person that I was talking to, his point was like, oh, well, they're not doing the lifts per se. What was he saying? He was saying along the lines of like, well, if the person's like natural, they should be able to do 400 for like 15. And I was like, bro, have you ever felt 400 pounds on your fucking back? That's a lot of fucking weight.
Yeah.
Like regardless of like how I feel with it, like I feel like 400 pounds on my back doesn't feel as heavy as it should.
Mm-hmm.
That's because I'm used to it.
Yeah.
But like you put anyone else under 400 pounds,
the average man,
they're gonna
yeah.
fucking die.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and it's like even if you have these giant bodybuilders with massive legs, and they're only doing like 400 pounds for like 5 reps. Even if they could do it for 5 reps, that's an achievement. That's
yeah.
good.
And here's
yeah.
the thing nowadays too with bodybuilders, they can make their arm look twice as big with just injecting synthol right into that muscle and it's going to grow. But they're not actually stronger. They look bigger because bodybuilding
right.
a lot of times is how you look. It's
yeah.
not how strong you are.
Right.
Well, like out here, at least in America, synthol is not as popular as it is in other countries.
Well, if it's used correctly, it's not actually a bad thing. But a lot of people with with all those things, they have a good use if they're used correctly. But people don't use shit correctly. They just, oh, you just do this. No. Like, it's not, it's about the proper way to do things. That's why I say, like, when someone picks one guy, oh, I like this guy, I want to do what he says. Check what he's done. Don't just look at his workout routine, look at his diet.
Mm-hmm.
Look at what steroids he uses, whether he stretches or not, you know. His genetics, was his dad a bodybuilder? Was his dad a bodybuilder? You know, if you're new and you have no experience, no family history, like you're skinny or you're fat, either one, look at someone that's walked that path and listen to them. That's why, like, when it comes to listening to you guys, I know we're different body types, but you guys are all natural. What you've done, there's results. That's why I can listen to them and be like, okay, look, okay, Adam's not over here juicing. Donald's not over here juicing. All you guys do is strength training.
Well, Don is, but
no, yeah, Don's been doing some. We won't talk about that.
Hey, man, I like my spinach and apples, like the green machine, like.
You like injecting
juicing.
Them, do you not? Yeah.
But, like, for instance, me and Adam, we do the same program, but Adam is just, like, fucking way different.
But
like,
you
need to put in
up
more
too,
work.
Though. Well, you still went up, too. But, yeah, you can tell, like Adam said, his dad was a bodybuilder. He has some of it in his genetics,
right.
which helps. But what I think helps Adam a lot, which I don't know, you would know more than me because you're yourself,
mm-hmm.
but is the fact that he doesn't think. He goes and he just lifts. He doesn't try to sit there and overthink it, like, can I do this? Can I do this? Or doubt. He just lifts it, and that's it. He tries to almost empties his mind. It seems
well,
like
for the... Like, the whole duration of, like, me lifting, I've learned that, like, I still have to, like, if my body wants me to listen to it, it'll make me listen.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I can't do anything about that. Like, there's
right.
been times where I've been forced to, like, listen to what my body is telling me because it's pain. So it's either pain or, like, soreness.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, last night when I was doing squats... My left lat was in pain. Like, enough pain that I couldn't breathe properly. I couldn't take big breaths. But I still finished my squats. So, like, the squat wasn't the hard part. The hard part was my lat not letting me breathe properly. So it's like, okay, well, I could just work around that. I could just put the bar higher on my back. That's why if you look at the squat video... I'm doing a high bar squat instead of a low bar. I'm not bent over as much. So, like, regardless, I have to listen to my body, like, sometimes. But most of the time, my body's fine. I wake up, and it's just like, okay, well, like, are we lifting today? My body, like, it's like, no, we're not lifting today. It's like, okay, well, then it's rest. Like, I want to eat a lot. if I'm lifting today, it's like I actually feel less hungry sometimes when I lift, and it's like I have to feed myself. It's like drink protein, then eat, then like eat again, because it's like you don't want to fuck up your muscle in the sense that, well, it's trying to grow, like you're not adding protein to your diet, then like what the fuck are you doing?
Right.
And
you get natural protein too. Like I've seen that you had to make like salmon and stuff like that. You'll get natural sources to go along with your supplement source.
Yeah.
That's good.
Like I try it, like right now I'm not doing as much as I want to, in the sense that like I want to start cooking again, but like I need to start getting back into like cooking my own meals and having like frozen meals that are just ready to go, and I know the ratios, so it's like either like I would have like written on it like, oh, this is like 2 cups of rice, like a certain type of rice, or like a quona or whatever.
Quinoa.
Yeah, quinoa.
Technical. I told you this motherfucker knows the correct term for everything.
So like quinoa is like a really good, like quinoa is a really good carb. It's a very good carb to have.
What the fuck is that, by the way? I don't
it's
know
basically it like little balls of rice.
Oh, okay.
Basically, like to put it
quinoa.
To put it in layman's terms, it's little balls of rice. So like for us, or like for me, I noticed when I did do my meals, I was like shitting a lot more, and I would eat a lot more, which is a good thing. So it's a, because it's like my body's utilizing all this shit. So I honestly need to get back into like meal prep. Like I actually, that's why I don't get like all these like videos that are like, oh yeah, you're tired of doing meal prep. It's like, no, it's like cooking's fun. Like, what the fuck are you doing?
But people don't want to do
people are
meal
lazy
prep, though. Yeah.
In a day where everything can be done on an app, nobody wants to cook. That's
but
the sad thing. The tradition's dead, man. It really is. Some people keep it alive. I personally like cooking myself, too. I cooked for 7 years as a manager at a restaurant, so I love cooking. Well,
yeah,
not anymore, but I did.
Yeah, I love cooking, too. So it's like,
It is fun, too. It's an art. It's an art, man. You can find out what you like. You design it instead of being like, going through a drive-thru and be like, yeah, can I get this with that? We'll take this off of it. Like, you can season your meat. You can make that shit down to exactly how you want it.
Well, like, for me, it's more so, like, I have control. Like, I would, like, after workouts, I would have, like, a certain meal.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like I would have, like, jasmine rice, like, probably a spiced jasmine rice in a sense.
Basically, you have your macronutrients, your fats, your proteins, and your carbs.
Yeah, so I would have my I would have like all my nutrients like in like these meals, and I would also have like my micronutrients too. So like I would have like a small cut of like a fish, or like most likely a salmon. So like a small cut of salmon, or like some other nutrients and stuff like that that I would have.
Yeah, macronutrients, by the way, means your
fats,
carbs.
And that's why I said micro. So I would also have the micronutrients.
I've never heard of
them. The vitamins and minerals are all micronutrients.
Okay.
Stuff that you don't normally get that are very important.
Are they like trace minerals? Like stuff like that? Trace minerals? Which,
yeah, I mean,
because the soils nowadays are depleted, so really we should all be supplementing with trace minerals because we don't get them out of our soils. Because people don't do what they used to do, which was compost piles and put the nutrients back into the ground. They all take it out. And so that's the reason for a lot of unhealthy people, is because we have depleted soils. It's why people are still hungry after they eat, because they don't get the actual trace minerals and nutrients that they're supposed to get.
Well,
on a different note.
It's actually interesting because like I could eat like 4 like clean meals that I cook. I could eat like 4 of them. But I could only eat like 2 Whoppers. That's it. For like a whole day, I can only eat like 2 Whoppers. And that will fill me the fuck up.
That's crazy, man. I'm not that way. I can eat and eat and eat, and I don't care what the fuck it is. you can just I have shit. A fucking fiery cauldron down there. It's like more, you know, which it actually hinders me because me trying to gain weight, man. It's like I have to eat so fucking much to even gain a pound. That's why, like, if we don't eat as much on a day, I eat like fucking 5 scoops of fucking mass gainer or protein. That bag's gone, a mass gainer already. That protein has like 1 scoop left because I'm trying so hard to keep them calories up, man.
But like that's the goal, like for you, like your goal is to like gain weight.
Yeah.
Right now.
Once I get to the certain weight, you know, obviously I'll just want to level out, which I want to be like.
Which wouldn't be hard.
Right, no. Once I get there, once I slow my metabolism down enough. Because really, like, people are like, oh, man, you're lucky when you have a high metabolism. It just depends on what your goals are, because low metabolisms are way better for building muscle. Way better for building strength and muscle. High metabolism is more for, oh, okay, you know, you can burn fat faster, you can burn calories faster, so you can be more cut. Well, depends on what your goals are, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And, like, my goal right now is mainly to stay like at my body weight, but like I know because of me eating out, like it's not gonna be that way. It's gonna go up. So like until I start getting on my bullshit with meal prepping, it's just gonna keep going up. And that's just the way that fast food works.
Yeah.
Like granted, fast food is still food. It's still cooked.
Yeah, it's
like
just
the same
on
way.
The digestive system because of the preservatives and shit in it. Like they shown a fucking McDonald's cheeseburger wrapped up, and they kept it wrapped up, and they left it for a year, and it was still the fucking same cheeseburger. Any other cheeseburger breaks down, but this cheeseburger was the same because of all the fucking preservatives. So you think about the if the air has that much trouble breaking it down, how hard does your digestive system have to work to break that down? You know what I mean? So that's where it's really fucked up for you.
But like what was it? Supersize Me? Like they showed
At the end of it.
They showed that a burger getting like with
hydrochloric
stomach
acid. Yeah, hydrochloric acid. Yeah, I've seen that.
Like it just turned black.
Yeah, like, it's like what the fuck? Yeah, like I know exactly what you're talking about.
The fries look exactly like what they look like out of the bag.
Jesus.
Like at the end of it. And somebody ended up like throwing away all of the food that he had in like the glass or whatever.
Granted,
so
since then
continue.
Some of it's changed.
Yeah.
Like the burgers are now 100% beef instead of whatever the fuck they were before because nobody ever said that. You know, 100% beef. So what the fuck were you giving me all those other years? You know what I mean? Like, but still, man, you know, in the bread and all that
mm-hmm.
shit still.
Oh, yeah, that's garbage.
Mm-hmm. God damn it, man. Garbage tastes good sometimes.
Yes.
But it's, but yeah, like, I've, like, me personally, like, I've had fast food, like, now where my body is just, like, processing everything. And it's like, okay, well, we need actual food now. And it's like, well, yeah, like, here's this fucking burger. And it's like, oh, no, like, we need, like, actual food.
I know what you mean, man. Because I have that feeling,
and
too.
And, like the next day when my body is like, well, we didn't have any real food yesterday, so like I'm just gonna fuck you up all day. And it's like, ah, oh, dude, like I feel so weak, like after like
that. See, I want to start doing that. I want to start writing down like the meal, how it made me feel. That way you know what your body wants. I know people that do that, and I've just never done it. Also, I've heard of blood type diet too. A big guy in Keokuk, his name is Matt Vincent, is actually related to Nate. Big jack dude. He said that follow a blood type diet. He's like, if you find out what your blood type is and look up blood type diet, he's like, I guarantee you, you'll feel energy from everything you eat. I was like, really? Which I have yet to know. I don't even know my blood type yet, but because you have to go and get your blood type. I was like, Mom, you ain't got nothing, no documents for my blood type? Nope. So.
Mine's AB.
I ain't got anything on mine either.
But supposedly, if you follow a blood type diet, you'll get food. You'll get the right food for your body.
Yeah, I'm a universal donor.
I thought that was O.
I think it is O.
Yeah, that's what it said on
then
the
AB is only for A and B donors.
And
you
A,
can
A,
do A
then
and B donors.
Then I'm O positive,
A, B,
I believe.
Maybe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm O positive.
Yeah, O positive is the one that's universal.
Yeah, because I know I'm universal because fucking when my doctors took my blood and they said, at the time, they said,
you may have like early onset diabetes. I'm like, no, I fucking don't. Shut the fuck up. Yeah. No, because they did the test to me literally right after I ate something. Like, you're not supposed to eat something when they take your blood. So I ate something.
That's going right into your blood.
Yeah. So, like, I ate something, like, literally 30 minutes before I showed up. And they didn't tell me, like, oh, yeah, you're not supposed to eat anything. Like, you're supposed to... No. Like, the paperwork that came later said you weren't supposed to eat anything for the test. But it's like... But they tested me, and now they think that I'm, like, early onset diabetes. And then they check me again. They're like, oh, it actually turns out you're not early onset diabetes. So it's like,
I'm about to slap some medication on you, man. You're about to go to town on you, another statistic.
You better get used to sticking yourself.
Yeah.
Prick, prick, prick.
But it's like, no, like, I know, like, right now I'm probably, like, unhealthy, per se. Like, in the sense that my weight, it's unhealthy.
Yeah.
But, like, it doesn't really affect me being, like, this big. Like, I still look the fucking same, but I'm bigger.
How much did you weigh when you ran that yoke?
I was...
289.
Almost 290.
Yeah, and you moved pretty quick for someone at 290 pounds with that much weight. I mean, yeah. I was moving fast.
Well, it's like, yoke is such, like, a good event for me when I actually care about it. Like, when I actually want to do it, it's, like, a really good event for me.
Last time we did it, before this program, it jacked up my shins, man. I got, like, shin splints.
Ooh, that's painful.
Yeah,
as fuck,
man.
Dude. Shin pain sucks so bad. Man.
I was like, man, I need to, like, start back down at the bottom again.
I still forget when a buddy of mine in Keokuk was training dog pound in MMA, and he used to BMX, so he hit his shins all the time on bike, and we go to both throw leg kicks and we connect shins. I'm like, oh fuck, laying on the ground, my shin had a lump on it like this. I look up and he's just walking. I'm like, fuck you, ow. Like, I seriously had the biggest fucking hump. It was like one of those cartoon knots on your fucking head, but on my shin. And he's just walking. Yeah, exactly. And he's just walking away. Like, I'm like, hey, fuck you, man.
He's like, I won this battle.
Yeah, the immediate reaction of me at the shin kick was like, oh, and him, me, oh, fuck. Like, it was painful, man. And that shin pain sucks. Unless you, I guess, BMX and have hit your shin so many times that it didn't affect you anymore. But for me, it sucked.
Well, I'm sure, like, even in BMX, it's still going to affect you, like, the first...
30 times or
30
so?
30 times
or so, until your bones are like, yeah, we're prepared for this shit now. That's a good thing about the body, to an extent. You beat it up and it gets stronger. That's the whole concept of lifting weight. Make beat your body up, and it grows back and fights back.
Mm-hmm. Speaking about lifting weight, we will be doing that on Monday, and we will be
peak week,
and I will be doing a 540 squat. No, 570.
Okay. That's right. Adam will be lifting heavy ass weight.
I believe it's 570.
Adam and Don.
No, Don lifts, like, my nephew could lift his weight.
And I lift fetus weight.
Yeah, it's 570. 570 for 2x4.
Maybe even under.
Or 4x2. Fuck you.
Technical, man. Technical.
You and your fucking fucked up teeth.
I'm doing 415 pounds for 4x2.
That's over... Yeah, that's getting there for you. It's not.
It's
it should be
430. Lighter than.
It should be 430, honestly.
We hope you enjoy your stay. It's good to have you with us, even if it's just for the day. We hope you enjoy your stay. Outside the sun is shining, it seems like heaven ain't far away. It's good to have you with us, even if it's just for the day.